Next topic for our session is going to be the quantization problem. That means what problem we are facing with the help of the or due to the quantization. Now, if I assume this particular process, then quantization problem is what? The quantization, first of all, let me explain that quantizer consists of two mappings. There are two mappings in the quantizer. One is called as the encoder mapping and the other one is called as the decoder mapping. So these are the two mappings. Encoder mapping is at the site of the source and decoder mapping is at the site of the receiver side. The encoder divides the range of values that the source generates into number of intervals. Now, what is the purpose of the encoder? Encoder is going to divide the range of values of the source, which is going to be generated into number of intervals. As we have seen in the earlier example, like we have taken -4 to 4. So it was what? It has generated the intervals and this intervals were generated by the encoder. What was that? -4 to -3, -3 to -2, and so on and so forth, right? Each interval is represented by a distinct code word. We have already seen that how we represented it with the help of the code word. The encoder represents all the source outputs that fall into a particular interval by the code word representing that interval. Now, as I have shown that, let's say if the value was 000. So what was the output we get, the decoder side? That was the range that lies between -4 to -3. This particular 000 was positioning between the interval of -4 to -3. That was the code word related to the decoding end. As there could be many, possibly infinitely many distinct sample values that can fall in any given interval, the encoder mapping is irreversible. In the earlier quantization session also, I told you that this mapping is irreversible. Now, why it is irreversible? Because I cannot decode it back whether this particular 000 is relating to the value, which value, either it is 0.36 or 0.37 or 38, whatever it is. So I do not know regarding that. So that is why it is irreversible. I cannot reverse it back. Now, quantization. Knowing the code only tells us the interval to which the sample value belongs that I have stated. It does not tell us which of many values in the interval is the actual sample value, right? When the sample value comes from the analog source, the encoder is called as analog to digital converter. Now, whenever we are getting the sample values from the encoder, then it is analog source, then we call it as the analog to digital converter. That means we are converting the analog into the digital source, right? Now, moving further, let's understand it in detail as we have done it. This is the encoder mapping. What is the purpose of encoder? The main work of encoder is to construct the intervals, right? The encoder mapping for a quantizer with 8 reconstruction values is shown in. So we have taken as the 8 reconstruction values. What are the 8 reconstruction values? From 0 to 7, right? From 0 to 7 means we all know how do we represent it in 3 bits. 000, 001, 010, 011, 100, 101, 110, and 111, that is 7. And the intervals are again -3 to -2, -2 to -1, 0, 1, 2, and 3. This is the input. So now moving further, the decoder selection. That is, what is the process or what is the main agenda of decoder? What does it do? It selects the reconstruction value. And this is very important, because the decoder at the receiving end is going to do what? It is going to reconstruct the value that has been encoded. So how do we do it? Now, we actually are losing a lot of value. As we were saying that here, 000 lies between -4 to -3, right? So here is a lot of mismatch or lot of loss of information. So what is the what is the, you know, temporary solution we had done is we have taken a midpoint of this particular, that is -4 and -3. It has the midpoint as -3.5. So whenever we get the input code as 000, we are going to focus on the point that the value will be -3.5 rather than -4 to -3. We cannot define it exactly. So we are going to define -3.5. Now you can see here, if you are defining -3.5, somewhere you are controlling the loss of information. It will give the value which is somewhere related to the 3.5. It will have the difference from this side also and from this side also, right? Next, from -3 to -2, it is going to give you -2.5, and the code will be 001. Why it is -2.5? Because it was from -3 to -2. So -2.5 is the mid value. Next, from -2 to -1, the value is what? The value is 011. So the output value will be 0.5, minus 0.5. Next we get 100. So 100 is what? From 0 to 1. The value will be 0.5, the midpoint of 0 and 1. Then we have 1 to 2. The code we get is 101. So instead of 1 to 2, I'll represent it with the value 1.5. Then I have 110. Instead of representing it from interval 2 to 3, I'm going to represent it with the value midpoint of 2 and 3, that is 2.5. And similarly, 111 will be denoted with the value of 3.5. Why? Because this is the midpoint of interval 3.5. So here we have reduced a little bit of loss of information by taking the midpoint of the intervals here. And this is how we are going to reconstruct the value, right? Now see, this is the encoder-decoder pair quantization. This is pair quantization. So what it is? How it is represented in the graph? Now see, this is the mapping for a 3-bit DA converter. DA converter, why? Because this is digital to analog. And if it was AD, that was analog to digital. Now here we have 000, which is, we can start from here actually, because we are getting this particular point. 100, we have what? 0.5. So 0.5 that is coming here with the value 1. Then we have 1.5. So this particular value is coming here. Then we have 2.5. So this particular value is here. So these are the midpoints of the intervals, and these are the intervals with the code words. And this is 3.5. So what I have done is I have created a stepwise. Similarly, at the other end, minus 0.5. So minus 0.5, which position? At the first position. Then 1.5 at this particular position. 2.5 at this particular position, then minus 3.5 at this particular position, that is at the 00. So this is again a step. So this is what? This is the complete graph of the quantization, that is encoder decoder pair quantization. So this is how we have the quantization problem. Now what all we have studied is defined in language, that is, for every code word generated by the encoder, the decoder generates a construction value. We have already seen, as a code word represents an entire interval and there is no way of knowing which value in the interval was actually generated by the source, the decoder puts out the value that in some sense best represents all the values in the interval. And that was what? That was the midpoint of the interval. Midpoint of the interval. So this value is generated by the decoder. If reconstruction is analog, the decoder is often referred to as digital to analog converter, right? So that's all for this particular lecture. Thank you. I hope you have understood this particular part. If you have any queries, you can tell me, you can ask me, right?